Hello everyone, thank you for joining my tutorials. Today we are going to learn how to create a false color composite image or band composition for Landsat 8. So first we should know what is a Landsat. So land means earth and sat means satellite. So Landsat means earth observing satellite. So how to download Landsat data? So for downloading a Landsat data, we'll go to UAGS Earth Explorer. So here is a UAGS Earth Explorer I have opened. For downloading the UAGS Earth Explorer data, we can download by choosing our four coordinate system, or you can also give name here. So what are the area I want to give, you can give, but if you know your area exactly, in which area your study area is there, if you want to know, if you have no, then you can press four coordinate here, exactly four coordinate you can give, or otherwise you can choose a shape file like a polygon or whatever the shape file you have, you can give. After that, a 4 point or shape file you have uploaded, then you can choose a date. So date will choose mostly at the summer time. Why? Because summer time, if you choose as a winter time or rainy season time, then what will happen, you will get more cloud there. So if you have get more cloudy data, then you could not able to predict something. We want to study land, so we'll choose an image which is having a very less cloud data. So for that I will choose as April month here mostly, because April there is a very less rainfall. So first I am choosing here, then and here I am choosing as a end of the April. Then I am going for the data set. After choosing data set, you have to go Landsat. In Landsat there is a land collection 1 level 1. In that I will choose a Landsat 8 OLI. So Landsat 8 OLI I will select here. So Landsat 8 OLI is already selected here. Then I am going for the result. When you will go for the result, you can able to see, if I will press here, you can able to see how much cloud is there in the area. See how much cloud is this in the image. If you want to see in metadata, metadata is data of data. Here is the cloud cover, land cloud cover, it shows 47%. So you don't want this kind of image which is having a higher land cloud cover. We want image which is having very less land cover or very less cloud cover. So for that we have to choose where the image is having a very less cloud cover. So in this area, if we'll see, this image having only 1.45%, means you can download this image. You should see there is a less than 20% cloud should be there. So when less than 20% cloud is there, you can able to download. So here is the download option is there. So I'll press here download option. Then GeoTIFF product you have to download, GeoTIFF. So when you will press download here, it will start download. It will take some time and it will download. After download it, it will look like this. I will show you. So this will look like this. You should have to install WinRAR in your computer system. So when you will install WinRAR, you can right click here and you have to press extract file. So when you will extract file, this will open like this. You will see 11 bands here mostly. Band, you can able to see 11 bands here. So what is that 11 band that I will show you? So mostly first I will give you the information about the Landsat. Landsat 8 is an American Earth Observation Satellite launched on 11 February 2013. It is a 8th satellite in the Landsat program. So first there is a Landsat 1, Landsat 2, like this there is a series. So the 7th to reach orbit successfully. Originally called the Landsat Data Continuity Mission. It is collaboration between NASA and the United States Geological Survey. So this data I have taken from the Wikipedia. So launch date is 11 February 2013. Landsat 8 launched in 2013. So orbit height is 705 km. Speed on orbit is 7.5 km/s. Then apogee and perigee you can able to see. Apogee is 703.0 km, and cost for this project launch is 85.5 crore mostly. So I was saying about the Landsat 8 having 11 bands. So what this band indicate? This is a range of wavelength. So band mostly shows the range of wavelength. So wavelength means for 0.43 to 0.45. So 30 meter resolution is there. 30 meter resolution, how you will see? I will show you. Image is having 30 meter resolution or what. So for that, I will drag the image. For dragging the image, I will go to add data. When I will go to add data, C drive, I have keep my data in D drive. I will go to D drive. So this is Landsat 8, what we have extracted here. When I will go, here is a band B1, then B2, B3, B4, B5, B6, B7, B8, B9. This kind of data is showing. Then B10, B11. So this first I will open Landsat 1. So when I will open this, it will ask me pyramid. So I will say OK. When I will press OK, you can able to see. If I will zoom it, when I will able to zoom it, you can see some pixel here mostly. Okay, some pixel is there. I will zoom another way. So this is dark area. So you can able to see some pixel is there. So when you will take measurement tool, here is the measurement tool, and I will click here to here. It will show a 30 meter. Okay, this pixel, one pixel shows 30 meter on actual ground. So this one pixel on the image 30 meter, it represent on ground 30 centimeter mostly. So this is the way to see. After that, you can able to see, you can go to properties. When you go to properties, in source you can read what is the format. Tip format is there. Its image is mostly 16 bits, so this is a radiometric resolution of the image. Then spatial resolution shows that WGS 1984, UTM zone 43 is given mostly. So this is projected image mostly. Then this is the 30 meter resolution. So what I am saying, that here resolution is given mostly. So Landsat band 1, band 2, band 3, band 4, resolution is given. So band 1 30 meter, band 2 30 meter, up to band 7 there is a 30 meter resolution. Then band 8 is a panchromatic, that is 50 meter resolution. So if I will drag the image of a band 8, or if I will add the image of band 8, this is the band 8, and I will add. So what is the difference you can able to see? It will show 50 meter resolution. As we have seen in the PPT, that 1 to 7 band is a 30 meter resolution, and band 8 is having a 15 meter resolution, that is a panchromatic image. So this panchromatic image, if I will zoom, so you can see pixel here. So this is one pixel. If I will go to measure tool and I will measure, then you can able to see the 15 meter resolution is showing. 15.49 means this one pixel is 15 meter, this other folder is a 15 meter. So this panchromatic image having a 15 meter resolution. So you can able to see this is a higher resolution than 30 meter resolution. So this area, if you will see on a 15 meter and if you will see on 13 meter, how much difference you can able to see? 15 meter resolution is a more clear than 30 meter resolution. So what we'll do, we'll take for a band composite, we have to need a same spatial reference and same resolution. for doing a band composite, if you want to create a false color composite, you should need all the resolutions same, all image having a same resolution, 30 meter, 30 meter, 30 meter, 30 meter, 30 meter. You can able to see all the images having a 30 meter resolution, and this one is a 15 meter. So, and this one is 9 band is having a 30 meter, but this is for the cloud study. So we'll not take this. We'll take 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. This 7 band we'll take for the band composite. We'll compose this. This 7 band is a different that we're going to compose. For the composing this 7 band, I will go to add data. When I will go to add data, I will see here band 1. I will add like that. You can add all the data from here also. You can add. For that you have to go catalog. In catalog, D drive, this is Landsat 8. In Landsat 8, so you can able to see this band 1. This is a B2, means band 2. Okay. Band 3. Band 4. Band 5, band 6, and band 7. So I am adding this band 7 here. I told you for band composite we need same projection. All the images having a same projection. If you all the bands having a same projection, you can able to see. If I will go and I will check that WGS 1984 UTM zone. So same projection is there, and it should have a same cell size, means 30 meter into 30 meter, means having a same spatial resolution. So this is 30 meter is a spatial resolution. This 7 band we have dragged here. So after that, dragging 7 band for compositing a band or creating a false color composite, we have to go a Landsat, we have to go R toolbox. In R toolbox there is an option data management tool. In data management tool there is an option raster. In raster, raster processing, in raster processing composite band option is there. In composite band we have to choose 1 to 7 image here by sequentially. So this is band 1. You can able to see this is band 1 B1. So it's band 2 B2, band 3, band 4, band 5, band 6, band 7. This band 7 I have added. Now output raster, where I have to save the data, I will choose as a output raster. So output raster I am selecting as a D folder. I am giving here as a band composite. Save. Then I will press OK. So it will take little bit longer time to composite a band. So you remember the tool in data management, there is a raster, raster processing, composite band. Or you can also directly search tool is there. In search tool, you can directly enter composite band, the tool will come here. So what is the composite band and what is the false color composite? Why we are doing it mostly? So if you want to know, there are two sensors mostly. There are two sensors there mostly. One is operational land imagery, another is thematic mapper mostly, thermal infrared mostly. So this TIR and OLI, OLI means operational land imagery, and TIR means thermal infrared here showing mostly. So this having a 100 meter resolution. Okay, this image is having 100 meter resolution. This is having a 30 meter resolution. So this 30 meter resolution, we have taken in this 7 band mostly, and this 8 band is a panchromatic, that is 50 meters. So we are not taking it for a band composite, we are only taking this 7 band. So after this 7 band, we can create a band combination for Landsat 8. So natural color mostly 432. If you select a band 432, it will show as a natural color. For showing a false color, it will 764. Now you can able to see band composite is created, that I will show you first. So we'll go to band composite. Now you can able to see some band 1, 2, 3 here. So if I will press here and I will go to properties. Now I was showing some symbology and I was showing some band option here. So this band is indicating a particular theme. So like a natural color, if I want to say, I will choose a 432, means red, blue and green, that I will show you 432. So I will give red as a 4, green as a 3, and this blue as a 2, and I will apply and I will okay. So it's look like as a normal color. Okay, this image we don't want, then we can remove it one by one. If you, we don't want it now because our false color composite is now created. So this, if I zoom, this is showing that it's a natural color, actual natural color is there, whatever the image. So this is water body, you can able to see. So in natural color composite, we cannot identify much more things. So we are going for the false color composite. For creating a false color composite, you can able to see false color is a, for urban area if you want to found. So 764 will choose 764. So go to band properties. Red I will give 7, 6 and 4. Apply. Okay. So you can able to see these changes. Here harmonic area will enhance. Then if you want to see the vegetation, then 543 you have to choose 543. If you want to see the vegetation, go to properties, choose 543, apply. Okay. So this red color indicating that this area is having a high vegetation. This blue water body shows that this color shows that the water body is there. This area shows that mostly this is also water body, and some settlement area is here also. So this kind of tool, using a band composite, you can create a false color composite. It's a very simple way to create a false color composite. So you can read much more detail about this. I have given some source link here. So from source link, you can detail, you can read in detail. So this is the, all of this is having a, I told you there are the 11 bands. This 9 bands is mostly having a operational land imagery, and remaining these 2 bands, they are mostly showing a, our thermal infrared sensor mostly. So, and again, you can able to see this is the band composite that I told you, false color, infrared color. For agriculture, you can choose this. Land, for land and water contrast, you can choose this. So these are mostly a band composite. You can try whatever your interest is there mostly. So these are all about band composite. So if you like my video, you can subscribe my channel. Thank you for watching my video. Let's will meet in the next video. Thank you for